Explosion is about to happen.
Hallelujah.
Of the Holy Ghost.
Let your Holy Spirit move, God. Let your Holy Spirit move.
Praise God. All wow.
Great things happen.
What a blessing to come in here and see all your praise and worshiping God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. That's a, you're fulfilling scripture. Did you know you just fulfilled scripture? I walked in to see the fulfillment of a verse. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy spirit, with all thy strength.
Amen.
And neighbor, I just saw.
Amen.
Wow. And we just saw scripture fulfilled. Wow. Whoa. And this is a day. I want to welcome you all to a new decade. Not just the new year, 2020. A new decade. A brand new decade. A brand new decade. A brand new decade. A brand new decade. Wow. 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 What is God up to? Everything. What is God up to? God. He's up to bringing the body of Christ together. So we've been getting a lot of prophetic words about what are you gonna do next, God? It's been awesome what you've done in my life, but what are you gonna do next? And he's bringing the body of Christ. Maybe somebody, she might already talk to you about Israel, but God's bringing the body of Christ. Hey, John, welcome, welcome.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And God's healing rifts between people. So if anybody in here has any division in their heart between them and some other person, if you laid your, put your head down and God gave you a name of somebody that you have had aught against them, well, let's not take that into the new year. Shall we just lay that down right now? Shall we just say, Lord, forgive me. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for the bad feelings that I had in my heart against this person and that person. Lord, and just name them, name them, name them. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Maybe it's a political party that you had something against. Maybe it's a candidate that you had something against. Maybe it's somebody, even that's gone, dead and gone, that you have something. But, Lord, we thank you for bringing those things to our mind right now. We thank you that you are cleansing us of all unrighteousness. We thank you that we're going into this new year clean, 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 holy, 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 righteous, 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 righteous. And thank you, Lord. We're just going to shake up that old junk. We shake up everything that would bind us, anything that would keep us from you, anything that is a distraction, because we want to focus on you 100%, because we're going into a new decade, and we're going in clean. We're going in holy, and we're going in anointed with the power of God and a river of God flowing out of our innermost being that touches everyone around us. An anointing that touches everything. If you're in a store, whether you're ducking down the street, in a park, it doesn't matter. Because God is in you, and you are in God. And that's a powerful thing. And you have everything you need. And people around you are affected by that Holy Spirit, and that's going to increase in this new decade, because that's what's going to heal the rest. And Lord, we thank you for helping us to forgive those we had something in. And now, Lord, give us love. Now we're asking a download of love. Everybody here, just grab it, receive it. A download of love. Direct it, just pull it in and stick it in your heart. Grab it, put it in your heart. Grab it, put it in your heart, more, until there's so much love that the deepest wound that you have against someone can be healed. Because when the second that your love for that person is greater than the spirit of offense and the spirit of anger, as soon as the love is greater, guess what happens? That scales just tip point like that. And then you are love. You are the love of God. You are the love of God. And that offense is gone. And the sin is forgiven. The sin is forgiven. The sin is forgiven. The sin is forgiven. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, brand new. A new decade. Brand new. And in this decade, God is bringing not only people together, but he's completing the work he's done in us to make us disciples. And to make you missionaries, to make you servants, of the Lord and prepare us for wonderful, wonderful works of service. Wow. Wow.
I agree with Miss Ella said about forgiveness, because I went through a lot in my life, you know, a lot of abuse and all kinds of abuses growing up, and God has really helped me to overcome it all and forgive the people. And to see now, we were just in Israel and in Romania and Germany, and to people what abused me, to go back and love them and hug them, and just awesome, because you know I was stuck, I was held back for years because I had unforgiveness. But the minute you forgive and let go, God can flow and God can do so many things. And I just see the changes in my family. I see the changes all over the world. And it's just unbelievable. I'm not sure if Miss Alice was talking about Israel. Started a vision like 30 years ago about bringing the gospel to the ends of the earth. And somebody had in the ends of the earth had a vision to bring back the Bible and basically to say the fulfillment is here and bring it back to the Jews. And what happened is it took them 10 years to get to the Jews and to ask them to invite them over. And this happened 2 years ago. The ends of the earth, we have people like almost 5,000 people from all over the earth, all over the nations, come together and bless the Jews and bring back the Bible. And then we were just in Israel. It was a new man conference. And what happened is, yes, in December. And what happened is there was a lot of repentance between the Jews and the Arabs, and the Arabs and the Jews. We were also on the mountain of rejection where they rejected Jesus, and the Jews repented, and it was just awesome to see history happen. It's just awesome. All over the world we have gone, where God sends Miss Allison and I, and sometimes Miss Margaret too. And it's just awesome what God is doing. We see it. Sometimes we just go, like we went to Russia, and the Lord just said, go. And then we found out they were passing a law that you cannot no longer come and be an evangelist in there. But the Lord sent us to worship and to pray. And we have seen it all over the world. So it's just awesome how God...
Yes.
Nothing stops him.
Yeah, nothing stops him. So we just thank you, Lord. And we went to the parliament and prayed at the Knesset in Jerusalem. And the last time I was there, I prayed at the embassy, you know, the new embassy in Jerusalem. And it's just awesome. I went there. I didn't know how to go there. And the bus driver took me. I knew exactly how many stops. And the bus driver said, no, you're not getting out here. And I was thinking, what's going on? But guess what? He dropped everybody else off and dropped me off by myself and said, thank you for what you are doing in this country. So it's just awesome. Everything happened. Everything that's happening in Iran, what's happening here, all over the world, it needs to happen. So Jesus is coming back for a healed nation. For thank you, Jesus. So we thank you for the mighty works you're doing and have done and going to do. And I've seen it in Romania when we went and prayed. And I had said to the Lord 5 years ago, send me anywhere in the world, you know, because he told me to take a year off. And I said, yes, I'll take a year off. Just don't send me to Romania. And of course, when he sent me to Romania. But we prayed all over the borders. We prayed in all the cities and connected with churches all over the world. And then what happened is, Ms. Alan and I, we were at the Black Sea, and there was no birds, there was no waves, there was dead. And we just prayed and repented and just looked at the water, the Black Sea. Yes. And repented for even the Jews, what they did to the Jews. And but what we saw afterward, we saw a hand made out of clouds. And Miss Alice, I said, Miss Alice, do you see the cloud, the hand? And the Lord said, I see, I got my hand, see, I have my hand over Romania. Yes. And the instant we saw that, guess what? We heard the waves, we heard
life
came
Romania.
Back.
Life
we have seen from death to life.
Yeah, life poured into Romania.
Yes. Wow. And we have seen it all over the world, so it's just awesome what God is doing, and He is doing the same thing here. He, like Miss Alice said, if unforgiveness is just stopping you, it's blocking you where you need to go with God. And for this year, yes, for this year, I just want more of God and less of me, and I want to be more in the spirit than in the flesh. And look like a fool, but I'm falling out. But I don't care, because all glory, all honor, all praise, because in the spirit, there is no pain, there is no nothing, and God is doing some mighty things. So if you really want Him to change you, just ask Him, because He is willing. He has changed me. He has healed me. What I am today, I had to go through things to become and have love for everybody, even the ones that rejected me and abused me. And it's just awesome what God is doing, using us all over the world. So thank you, Jesus.
I watched her whole life change when she forgave her parents, and when she forgave some things, a lot of terrible things. She was raised under communist government, so she has to go terrible repressions, terrible situations. You don't know what this girl went through. She doesn't talk about it. I'm just saying that, oh, with all of that, when she faced that pain, and when she went back and put her feet on that ground and forgave and started pouring love in all the places where she had pain, she poured love. And when she poured love on that thing, everything, and God forgave her for the hardness in her heart, not just what was done to her, but the hardness. Because what happens is when somebody does something to us, we're still guilty because we have hardness, bitterness, and hate, or whatever it is, or we avoid that, or we don't even want to be with it. We withhold love from that person. And so we have sin on our part too. And when it got healed on her side, when she put that before God, I watched her completely change. And we surprised her parents, who hadn't seen her how many years? 15 or any several years. He had never even talked to them. And He completely restored that relationship. And her parents were blessed, and they're growing in the Lord. And everything now, everything changed. Because what had happened, like she was saying, those kind of unforgiveness thing, it puts a blockage. When God's trying to bless you, and it's just like a stream of living water coming out and getting blocked by the stones, the hard places that we have put in. And we wonder why God doesn't bless us more. But I tell you what, the more we lay those things down, the more we love, the more we forgive, it removes all of those obstacles. And now she's just this wild person before the Lord, because she's free. She's free. Free. Everybody say free.
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 Free. Free.
And say, I am free.
I am free.
In Jesus.
In Jesus.
And I forgive.
And I forgive.
Everyone.
Everyone.
That has ever done anything to me.
Ever done anything to me.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.